What's going on, guys and gals? Kendall here for Renos for Pros and Joes, helping you simplify the renovation remodeling process. On this channel, we do tip and strategy videos for property renovation, repair, and maintenance, as well as hands-on product tooling gear reviews. So if you're a home buyer, a homeowner, a home seller, a DIYer, a realtor, a tradesperson, a contractor, or aspiring to be in any one of those groups, consider subscribing because you may find videos here that are of interest to you. Okay, now that we've got that out of the way, in this video, I'm gonna be sharing my experience the first time that I used a pre-mixed lime wash. And as you can see in the video here, I am spraying down the first wall that I am going to be using lime wash on. One of the first things that you wanna do is mist your brick to make sure that it is ready for lime wash. Okay, so now you see me here adding water to a bucket that I'm going to be mixing the lime wash in. I have already read my instructions, even though you don't see me do it on here. I'll do it a little bit later on in the video for a second time for those who are in doubt. So as I pull the cap off of the lime wash here, you can see, even from my expression here on the video, that I'm a little bit surprised in the way that it looks once I've got the bucket open. I was expecting it to look something similar to a paint product, but it is so much thicker. So I start by adding a little bit of water to the bucket that I'm going to be mixing in. And as you can see, I lean the bucket over here and nothing came out. So I shake it up a little bit and then I try it again. Crickets, nothing. So I step away and go and get a paint stick to assist in scraping out some of the lime wash into the small bucket where I will begin to mix it in small batches and then add it to the big bucket. So as you can see here, I am pushing lime wash out of the bucket with the stick. It is extremely thick. I can't express that enough. So then I begin to mix here with my paint stir stick. And I may add a little bit more here to make sure that I've got enough. One of the things that you have to be concerned about when you are mixing up lime wash is to try to create a consistent mix. That's going to be the most difficult thing to do with regards to application because the consistency of the lime wash is going to affect the tone and transparency that the lime wash has when you begin to apply it. And so it's best to try to mix your lime wash in a batch that's going to be sufficient enough for you to cover a particular area. So in this scenario, I'm trying to make sure that I mix enough lime wash to cover this entire wall so that I don't have any major variations in color. So here you see me again, referring back to the instructions on the side to make sure that I am doing this right. And I'm going to add a little bit more water here, and then I am going to continue to mix. So another thing that you want to keep in mind when you are doing a lime wash project is the weather. You want it to be warm, but you don't want it to be too hot. And you also want to make sure that it's dry outside and you don't have any rain forecasted in the near future. You see in this video, the sun is directed onto this side of the house. So you want to be mindful of that because that is going to directly affect how long the lime wash takes to dry out and cure out. So if you don't have sunlight directly shining on your surface that you're going to be lime washing, it's actually probably a better thing, but in some scenarios it's not going to be possible. To jump back, you see that I'm still stirring here. In retrospect, I should have used a mixer and a mixing drill in order to mix this properly. That would have given me a much better opportunity to have 100% success the first time, but you live and you learn. And that's why I'm making this video, so that you all can learn from the things that I would do differently next time around. So here I am still mixing. We are going to have a guest in this video. Believe it or not, on the route of this particular property, the male guy is extremely friendly. So I have done my best to cut him out of the video as much as possible. I want to keep folks working around here. But you will see him in here more or less for comic relief. He's going to be in and out, but you won't see his face. And then eventually we'll see him finally pull off and then we will continue with the work. So I've got it mixed up as much as I can here. And now I'm going to go back at the recommendation of the mailman and go ahead and pull off all of the nails that were nailed into the brick. I did see them when I was doing my initial spray over and didn't think it was gonna be that big of a deal. It's kind of one of those things I can kind of address as I work, but to appease my assistant, I went ahead and pulled all those out. And so I've got one or two more here that I'm addressing. And once I get that done, I will begin to spray. So, thanks, mailman. So one of the things that I did that I did not mention in the article, I believe, is I initially tried to use a inexpensive battery-powered sprayer to apply the lime wash. And I kind of knew on the front end when I was mixing up this product that it probably wasn't going to work. But what I was figuring was that it would be so much easier for me to clean out the lime wash out of this little sprayer versus a complete airless sprayer setup. So there you just saw the mailman take off, and I'm trying to clean out my battery powered sprayer. Unfortunately, I had to cut out the portion where I tried to use it because he was just completely in the frame the entire time. Now I've got the airless sprayer out and I'm ready to go ahead and start setting this thing up to begin to rock and roll. You see there on that right bottom corner of that wall, you can see where I tried to use it with minimal success. One thing about the airless sprayer is that it greatly speeds up the time that it takes to apply the lime wash, just like it does for paint products. However, you are going to have a considerable amount more time in setup and cleanup and prep. So just keep that in mind if you're considering doing this with a paint sprayer. And also in retrospect, if you read the article, then you know that I had all types of issues with this lime wash getting clogged up in my sprayer. And had I known or had a little bit more experience with working with it, I would have done things a little bit differently with that phase of it as well. I would have removed the filters immediately after I was done, and I would have washed this sprayer out immediately after I finished using it. So I can't say definitively how much that would have affected the process of being able to clean the sprayer out. However, I can tell you that after letting a few days pass without having cleaned it out after using it for lime wash, not cleaning it out thoroughly, I should say, the filters were completely wrecked. So I had to replace the filter in the housing part of the sprayer, and I also had to replace the filter in the gun. This was something that I was not expecting to do, but it was necessary, so I did it. So here you see that I am spraying the lime wash on here, and it's going on relatively okay. It does not spray on as easily as paint does. And as you can see, I'm kind of whipping the sprayer there back and forth, and you can see me stop and twist the needle on the gun periodically because it gets clogged up with lime wash. Regular paint doesn't really do that. So in any case, I continue to work on this wall in kind of small little sections because it comes out very slowly. As you are working through the process of whether or not you're going to lime wash your house, you should also consider using a brush as opposed to using a paint sprayer. The brush is going to be much slower than using a sprayer like this. However, I believe it will probably result in less wasted product, and it may be a little bit more forgiving with regards to trying to work out your coat. But the next thing I want to mention with regards to lime washing a house is it's helpful if you already have a pretty good idea of what you want that house to look like in the end, as an end result. Because for me, I thought that I initially wanted to have a transparent coat on here, and that was the look that I was really going for. So if you can see here, I've got the lime wash on here in a very light coat, and you can still see some of the character of that red brick. I did actually go back and touch up some areas on this that I don't have on camera, but one of the things that made this overall project fail was that the way that this lime washed brick looked just didn't suit the look that we were going for. So by the time I had gone through the process a few times and tried to wash it off and even went with the different style of having some highlighted areas where the lime wash was applied a little bit thicker in some areas and lighter in others, still didn't look quite right. And I attribute this to the style of the home as well as the overall roof line of the house and the color of the brick, because it just didn't really pop. And you'll see here when I change sides of the house here that I'm jumping over here to the front and I'm gonna do the same thing. But the color just really didn't ever look exactly the way that I wanted it to. And that's one thing I would caution you on. Ultimately, if you have already read my article, then you know that I decided to just scrap the whole lime wash idea completely and ended up painting the house, and I'll have some photos of that at the end. But the look that I was going for was pretty much a all white uniform look. Once I tried to use the lime wash and give the semi-transparent look or the uneven finish, it just wasn't a look that suited this property very well. So I ended up just painting everything one color, and it ended up coming out pretty good. From a cost standpoint, I'd say that they're probably about the same. If you're going to be using a high quality paint, the paint is going to run you about the same as the lime wash when you look at the coverage that you're going to get. I would encourage that if you are considering doing a lime wash project on the exterior of your home, make sure that you have looked at enough photographs online that are going to give you a good idea or a good representation of what your property may look like when you go through this process on your own, whether you pay someone to do it or you do this thing yourself. If you have a paint sprayer, I would probably recommend that you not use it to do this type of project just because of the amount of cleanup that is involved with using it after you're finished with it. And I certainly wouldn't go out and buy one because you're not going to have the necessary familiarity with the tool in most instances to be able to thoroughly clean it so that you can use it for years and years to come. Another thing that I will say in comparing paint to lime wash is that the paint is much easier to work with because it is already mixed and the color that you're going to get out of it is going to be uniform. With paint, you may have to apply two coats, but ultimately you know that everything is going to be consistent if you've mixed it up properly before you've taken it out of the bucket, which they typically would do at the store. So with all those things being addressed, you're going to get a much more uniform color and coat. And if that's the look that you're going for, I recommend using paint as an easier solution. Now, if you are more of a risk taker and you're willing to go through the same process that I did, which is basically trial and error, then go for it. However, I certainly would not recommend using a paint sprayer. And by all means, if you are considering renting a paint sprayer to do this, I just wouldn't do that because the tool rental place is going to skin you alive when you take it back. So, hopefully you guys found this video informative. If this is your first time watching one of my videos or going to the website, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you've got additional questions about this lime wash project or you've got some feedback for me, leave that in the description box below. As always, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys on the next one.